Welcome to my channel. My name is Bullet Lee and we're gonna try to make paper goodies, okay? Let's do it. I'm pumped. I have these popsicle sticks, and these popsicle sticks, I did not eat the ice cream and wash it under the sink. No, these are I've bought in a bag. I don't have the bag anymore. Let's see. It's in the back of my chair, inside my cupboard. Oh gosh. So I've unloaded every popsicle in the bag and I've put it in this aluminium bucket. Well, I don't know if you know these. These were when there was not Corona. And I was at Starbucks and I stole some popsicle sticks, some coffee sticks. So I have these also. I have no popsicle sticks where I've eaten the ice cream and washed it down. It's okay to do that, but I'd rather not. So these are brand new, stinking cute. And we're gonna do some things with these. Let's see. I have some die cuts that I've done previously in some months ago, and luckily I have some of those. And I need this foam double-sided tape, this one, and I have something here in the corner. But I cannot find it anymore. That's strange. This is very annoying. I don't have it anymore. Where is it? Oh. I have a little problem. I know. I found them in the corner. So, I have eaten some bonbons in a rectangular box, and then you got these paper. I call it paper bubble wrap, and it's on top of the bonbons to ensure that those bonbons, chocolate bonbons, are not crushed. So you can do it the same thing. I'm going to show you. These are the mini crackers packaging. And I've kept the bag, of course. What I want is the inside. So you can throw the bag away. So what you can do is with this, you can call it cardboard. And do the same thing with the paper bubble wrap, and find a washi tape. Of course, do it the other way around, it's better because that's flat side. And then with the pencil, then you mark it a circle and cut it with your pair of scissors. That's what I did with these paper bubble wrap. And so you can use that, of course. So I'm not gonna do that now, but I know you understand what I mean. So what you need is you get a popsicle stick and you look for, well, how deep you wanna put it, like totally up the top part or just halfway. It's what you think it's best. So of course, if you do it totally on top, then the part of the stick will be shortened, but if you're okay with that, it's not a problem. It's just you want to make some cute decoration with this popsicle stick. So what you're gonna do is you grab a little bit of this foam double-sided tape and you stick it. That's already the sticky part. And you cut it off. Then you rub it to take care that the double-sided tape that is glued onto the popsicle is stuck well enough. So now you're gonna take the paper lining or the backing of the double-sided tape. I have always a problem with this because I like to cut my nails short, and then when I decide to craft, I'm like, oops, maybe I should have craft first and cut my nails later. So then you got this already glued on the popsicle stick. You grab some paper. You can of course use a thicker cardboard. It's not a problem if you use that. And then you put it in the bag. So I'm gonna do it like halfway, like so. And then you look inside the book for stickers. And I've seen them. Let's see. Here are some stickers. Which part shall we use? This one. See? And then put it like so. Then, of course, I didn't round it very enough. So you can, of course, use it lightly. So, now you have a nice goodie for this. But then you say, hey, but Millie, you made these paper dies. What you gonna do with that? Well, you can do that the same, but you can layer that. So we're gonna do it the same. I'm gonna grab a popsicle and put it on a piece. Then turn around and then cut. Like this. Okay. Then I'm gonna use another one again and glue it halfway again and do a little piece. Put it in the center. So now I'm gonna do some layering. Oh, glued to my finger. And then grab a pink one. So if you wanna do it correct, that's why I turned the popsicle in the back. I'm gonna choose which side is best, this one or this one. I think I'm gonna glue it on this side. So now I've taken the lining or the backing of the double-sided foam tape. I'm gonna put it in the center like this. So now I have layered it. So now I want to decorate this part. I have a I cannot show you because it's a box with all these plastic boxes in, and I can just take it out which box I need to use. It's the same as when you go to your father's garage and he puts in the same box, he puts all his nails and all these things, the silver things that he have to use when he does this wood crafting and stuff. So it's the same box, but I use it for to put my die cut and my washi tapes and flake stickers. So I'm gonna use these. Let's see. It says here eucalyptus. That's nice. I'm gonna find another. Do it like this. Okay, let's do that. So I have found two flake stickers, and the problem is with flake stickers. Oh, there we go again. Millimeter short nails. We're gonna laugh. So I'm trying to take the backing off. This time it's not paper backing. It's transparent. Plastic backing. And as you can see, I have a very hard time. Ah, there it is. You see? That's the plastic backing. And we're gonna decorate this beautiful doily. Like so. I can even use it like this without. Oh, this one is nice. You know what? I'm not gonna decorate with the other flake stickers. We're gonna do another one. Wait. Because it's keeps sliding off. Let's do another one. But then with this eucalyptus sticker. Okay? Let's see. Need to do it again. Let's see. And this time I'm going to use the green part. So not the pink one. And I want to use this again, so let's do that again. Do the same thing, cut a square. It doesn't matter how much you can cut and use, just put it in the center. So we can use the green part. So I want to do it exactly in the middle, in the center, so that's why I turn it around. And then use, of course, another piece. Oh no, I'm not gonna use this one. I forgot, I need to sticker it. So, but I need to find another piece that's beautiful. Shall we use the blueberries for that? Let's see. Or a more leafy one. Shall I use a more leafy one? Let's see. I have so many stickers in here that I can choose from. Ah, maybe this one. Oops. I'm gonna put it in here in case I change my mind. So let's see. Oh, I like that. Okay, let's do that. So let's take the backing off of this flaked washi sticker. Okay, I did it very quick this time, and try to do it centered like this, and I use this sticker. I'm gonna put this back in the box. So you can do a lot of different kind of decorations with this. the backing is glued to my nail. That was funny. Okay. Like this. Oh, wow. So let's do another one. It's so much fun. Oh, it fell. It won't stay. Okay, do another one, but this time with the die cut instead of the stickers. Let's do the other side. This time a bit bigger. I can of course cut it more bigger than I've just cut. Because I don't know exactly how big the die cut is gonna be. I don't know which one I'm gonna choose. So let's see. Shall we use? No. I just want to find. Oh, this one is nice. You're gonna use this one. Okay, so now we have spillage. So that means it's gone outside the die cut, so I'm gonna cut carefully, only the back side, of course, not the die cut itself. So there you go. Nice! Look, I have another one. So now I have four different ones. That's good. So let's put these away. So what I want to do is now I have this one. Where is it? Oh yeah. I have bought a very big metal die, and luckily it fits snugly into my die cutting machine. So I used one of the thicker quality paper, and I've run it to the die cutting machine. So it's this one. So I have taken all these bits out. So now you can, I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna grab this memo pad paper. You have like a stack when you can buy it in the store with different kind of colors. So I've just grabbed the blue one. So you can put it like so. So you can see some of them are, I've used a toothpick to prick all these elements that I want opened. And some of the elements I've have it shut. This one just flew out before I've started filming. So it's on my desk, so I need to find it and then put it back in place. So now with the other one, you don't have to use blue. Just imagine this is another color, and put it in its place. Of course, this paper is short. You can, of course, find another piece of colored paper that is a bit bigger. And you can use it just like so to make like a beautiful colored fun canal house. We call it canal houses in Amsterdam, and you can of course make it as a card, like I said. Just you can use different kinds of colored paper and then glue it onto the paper, so you can have with this one colored space, you can write a beautiful note or a quote or a letter. So I have made one of these already. So now I'm gonna try. So that's the goodie that I've already pre-made before filming. So now I'm gonna make one with this beautiful metal die, and I'm gonna use this paper. So this is the dark green one with the bugs on each corner, and with this beautiful illustration. So I need to cut with my paper cutting machine, this one, cut into the shape, because this paper is way too big. It will not fit my die cutting machine. So I'm gonna cut how much I need. Let's see, how much do I need? Alright. So now of course this side is also way too wide. I need to cut it. So now I'm gonna clean it up and by putting the paper cutting machine back on the shelf. And of course I need to use these. Oh, I need to take all these popsicles. Yeah, I know my desk is messy right now. I'm sorry for that. Oops. Let's see. So I'm gonna take the first acrylic plate out. And let's see. Wait. Of course, like this. And then put it in its place. Try to run it to my die cutting machine. Okay, let's go. And then back. And then another time. So I'm gonna do it back and forth in total 3 times. Then, in order to take back my plate with the, of course, inside the metal die, and pattern paper. All right, I've slapped myself. So I'm gonna push it through, and then, of course, I can take these outside paper out. But as you can see, it didn't cut. Oh. You know what? I'm gonna use a pair of scissors. I'm gonna push, let's see, the acrylic plates back into the space. and try to cut it myself. Okay, so this little piece, I can put it aside and try to fold where I need to fold. So I can choose like the box gonna be shown, the tree side or where the bug is. So I'm gonna use, of course, the tree side. Just see. Oh, I did it wrong. this is half of the box. I need to do it another. I need to run it another. Because it's just half of the box. Well, you understand my meaning. So, I'm not going to show you. But I'm going to tell you through it. So, you're going to grab another piece of paper. And then run it through again. So, you can finally put the other half in. And glue it. You can use glue. Or use double-sided tape. The tin one. I mean, the tissue paper ones, I mean the very thin one. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. My throat is a bit dry. So this is the part. That you can hear. You need to fold it. Like so. So that's the other half. Of course, you need the other half again to make it complete. So you can have a box version. It's almost a candy box version or a milk carton box. So let's pretend I just made it complete. So next one is let's see. I have another metal die where the pattern is like a knitted sweater. It's the same pattern as the knitted sweater, but I wanted to have the wavy part. So that's why I want to use this. So I'm gonna run this also through the die cutting machine. So let's see. Did I do it correct? No, I need to see it. Let's see. Normally, if you're not sure about it, you can use washi tape to put it in its place. So, but I don't. I just do it without the washi tape and just run it through the die cutting machine. So all I want is the structure or the relief, or how do you say, the print of the knitted sweater, but then I want to, like, the pattern paper. It's not a very thin pattern paper, it's quite thick. I think it's gonna look very beautiful. Let's see if I can, like this. So, oh, you can see the structure and you can feel it also. It's very sharp. You can see it here. And I don't know if you can see it. It looks like leaves also. So now this has some kind of, you can feel it also. So this is very, how do you say it? Smooth, but this part not. So I want to do like some kind of card, like that. So here, you open it, you can feel it like, oh, you can call it a nice feeling, or maybe some people are. And when you just, I've folded in here, you can see it even, the leaf prints just opens up a little bit. When you close it, you don't see it. So that's very nice and a bit funny also. So I've made a paper with structure. Okay, so next, what shall we use? Oh yes, of course. I'm gonna grab something. I have a box. I have a lot of boxes, but this one is on my desk on the right. And this is Pear Caramel. These are tea bags. So of course you can gift someone a tea bag, but you can. These are the tea bags that I've already used. And all what's left are the pockets, the envelopes. So you can use that also to put beautiful things in there. So I'm gonna use like two as a pocket. Let's see, what shall we use? Need to look for something in the book itself. Let's see, what can I use inside the book? So, where's my pair of scissors? I have here a page with stickers. And I'm gonna cut, oh, you know what? I'm gonna move the die cutting machine. And I need to cut it right through in the middle. Oh, shoot. I've cut through the other. I didn't feel properly. I cut in the middle of the other. That's weird. Well, it doesn't matter. So now I have, like, this won't fit, of course. So I'm gonna fold it three times. Let's see. like so, and just put it in one of these envelopes, and you have with stickers. Of course, you can put a little bit of washi tape in there, and then you have another one. Let's see, is there something inside the book that I can use? Let's see, what can I use? I can, of course, take it of some, I can cut some of these papers that you can make DIY origami leaf, and the other one, the butterfly. But I've also things besides me, like these. These from the Flying Tiger. This is just a decorative tape. I'm gonna cut a little bit out, so we can use it also. A little bit bling bling. Never hurts, of course. See, can I take it out? I cannot take it out. I'm gonna use one of these legs. Yes, you see? If I have a hard time taking or opening the box, I'm using one of these legs. So let's see. It's quite long. I'm gonna cut half of it. Like this, and then roll it. You see how big I need to roll it? Like this. And put it, of course, inside. Like that. And of course, because I've rolled it up, it tries, of course, to uncoil it. So I need a good kind of sticker. I'm gonna use this one. To stick it in. Inside. Oh, a bit uneven. Let's see if I can. Ah, done. See? So now you have two used tea bags, and just like I said, put the stickers in or whatever. And this one is with the beautiful tape with stars, and of course, I can put more stickers in one of these bags. And just put a bunch of stickers there. And then use a little bit of washi tape to close it. And that's another paper goodie that I have. Then, of course, I have this little piece of paper left. So I'm gonna use the corner punch to take out the corners. As you know, I don't like sharp corners. So now it's beautiful formed. I need a toothpick and a washi tape, and then find the place that you want to cut. You can do it with your toothpick and then punch a hole in it, or you can find a puncher with a hole in it. You can use, of course, the regular puncher with the two holes in it when you want to punch a normal lined paper. You can use that also, and use one of the holes. You have two holes. One of the holes you can, of course, make the hole that you are acquired, like this. And then you find, let's see if I can find